November 21st, 1943, America launched its first major amphibious assault on a Japanese island stronghold. America's first target was Tarawa, a part of the Marshall Island Group and an important link in Japan's Central Pacific defense shield. The Japanese built an airstrip on the coral reef island of Baisho and sent in over 2,600 Japanese Imperial Marines and 1,700 Korean laborers to defend her. Tarawa's commander boasted to his garrison that 1 million Americans couldn't take Tarawa in 100 years. Over 35,000 U.S. naval and marine forces were assembled for the invasion. On board the first wave of attacking Higgins landing craft, Ensign Leon Cooper was responsible for the lives of hundreds of men. By day's end, nearly 1,500 of the 5,000 Marines at the beachhead were either dead or wounded. After 3 days of some of the most intense, bloody fighting of the war, the island was taken. Only 17 of the Japanese defenders survived. America lost 1,112 Marines and sailors, and 2,300 were wounded. Now, nearly 65 years since the invasion, Leon Cooper will return to this island on a journey of redemption and action.
You see, we are surrounded by garbage everywhere, but also there is shit on this beach, which of course is the most appropriate signification and symbol of everything that's wrong with our goddamn government, allowing not only garbage but shit to accumulate where so many guys died.
In addition to the massive garbage and refuse that now covers the hallowed red beach, Baisho is still littered with the remains of that great battle, including live ammunition as well as the possible remains of American soldiers.
The ordnance keeps turning up, but there's a whole range of stuff that just keeps turning up all the time. You know, there's a 500-pound bomb we discovered. It was one side of a chicken coop.
And we found a complete skeleton, still had partial uniform, boots, watch, and the fiberglass liner. And the name on the front of his fiberglass liner was PFC Soam.
Leon Cooper is taking action.
A meeting with the Kiribati representatives, member representatives of the Kiribati government, getting an action program underway, initially to clean up the garbage on Red Beach and elsewhere on Tarawa. Many thanks again, Mr. Ambassador, for your great work. I decided to come and personally get involved in getting an action program underway. For more than 3 years, I've been trying to get our government to do something about the desecration that has happened to the beaches where so many Americans died in defense of our country. It outlines the things that I want to do to help you. Initially, it will involve the employment of citizens of Kiribati. He came to the Coast Watchers Memorial, a beautiful memorial to those guys who gave their lives in defense of their country and ours too, by the way. And the Brits, the Australians, and the New Zealanders are memorialized here, but Soames is not. He lies here somewhere where I'm standing in an unmarked grave.
After nearly 65 years have passed, there are still many unanswered questions and a disastrous environmental legacy that remains on this tiny atoll, as well as the many other islands throughout the Pacific. This is a story of one man's journey to reconcile the past and reclaim the future.